Order up.
Thank you. Folks, welcome. Welcome once again to the Quiet Room. Join me as I eat this peanut butter and jelly sandwich and have a nice Coca-Cola, and we discuss some important topics. Welcome once again to the Quiet Room. It's nice to have you guys with me tonight. Take a little sip of our Coca-Cola. We have a nice peanut butter and jelly sandwich tonight. And let's go ahead and move in a little closer. You guys, what I want to talk about this evening is basically the importance of your diet. As we enter 2020, I don't want you to get too caught up in letting the others bring you down with this type of language. Oh, you're a New Year's resolutioner. You're just gonna say that you're gonna lose weight and get healthier this year, but we all know you're gonna be fatter next year. We all know you're gonna go to the gym for the first 2 weeks and then give it up. Listen, there's naysayers out there everywhere. And I guarantee you 85% of those people are people who have tried to do that themselves and have failed. So they're speaking from experience. So don't let their failed experience weigh down on your goals, okay? Because it's January 4th, it's 2020, and ladies and gentlemen, we've gotta get things right. We've gotta get things healthy and we gotta get things moving. So Hunto's here, I'm gonna give you some tips and tricks for the new year. I've got everything you need to know when it comes to diet tips and tricks, okay? Now there's many different diets that you can choose out there. And you can choose keto, paleo, you could choose intermittent fasting, you could do the vegan diet, whole foods, plant-based, you could do vegetarian, you could do pescatarian, you could do vegan until 4 and then carnivore. You could literally make up any type of diet you would like to follow. Now, here's my suggestion to you. I want you to focus on 3 main things for the new year. Sleep, your water intake, and your fruit intake. Now these are the 3 most important things for your diet. You can eat all these other foods that you like, and you can even eat foods that are not as healthy as things like fruit and vegetables. But the key is that you're eating enough fruits and vegetables, mainly fruits. If you really, really, really don't like fruits, you can do vegetables as well. The thing with vegetables is they don't have as much glucose, sugar, starches as fruits do, so they don't power you with as much energy. So if you're going to be eating a bunch of veggies for the first meal of your day, you're not going to have as much power and as much energy as you would if you were to eat fruit. So, keeping that in mind, I want you guys to keep on track of those 3 things for this new year, because those are very important. Your sleep is so important for circadian rhythm, and a lot of people don't realize that every night when you sleep, you're actually going through very, very important stages of your digestion. Now, your digestion matches with your circadian rhythm. And if you know anything about the way that the human body sleeps, it enters different stages of different stages of depths of sleep. So there's REM sleep, there's all the other types of sleep. REM sleep is really the only one that I technically know the name of at the moment, so I don't wanna make myself sound like an idiot. But my point is, you wanna wake up every day after sleeping ideally for a nice 8 hours. Now, every night you go to bed and every night you wake up, I want you to analyze how your sleep was. Did you hit the full 8 hours? Not only did you hit the full 8 hours, but were you consistently sleeping nice and deep for the whole 8 hours? How many times did you wake up through the entire night? These are things that you should be keeping track of. And even if you have to pull out a notebook and start writing them down, it's important, you guys. We need to make changes and make better habits for this year, so if that means you doing stuff that you're not really wanting to do, you know, suck it up. Because you gotta fucking grow a pair and you gotta get somewhere with this health, so make sure you're sleeping enough. One of the things that I didn't mention that's also very important is exercise. If you're always at the gym every day, doing some type of either cardio or weightlifting, you're gonna be tiring yourself out and it's gonna make it so it's a lot easier for you to fall asleep at night. If you you're one of those people that has issues with falling asleep and sleeping, that's definitely something you're going to want to hone in on is your exercise. So make sure you're drinking water every morning when you wake up, at least a quart. Now that might sound like a lot, but it's very important. Because not only should you be drinking a quart of water every morning when you wake up, you should be drinking a quart of water before every meal. Now, these are things that I've gone over before on my channel. If you guys have seen my Hundo's Health program, it's a free program that I've uploaded here. It's on a playlist, a separate playlist. I believe it's under the Planet Hundo Health, so go check that out now if you want to follow along for about a 13-day, basically, program where I explain a lot more of this in depth. So, lastly, the one thing that I want you to keep on track of is your fruit intake. Most people don't eat fruit at all. And even the people that do eat fruit don't eat enough fruit because they only eat one or two pieces of fruit and they call that good. You need to be eating minimum 7 to 10 pieces of fruit per day. I want you to make that your staple goal for this year. 7 to 10 pieces of fruit per day. If you are staying on that, staying on your water and getting good sleep, you will see bigger differences in your digestive health than you've ever seen before in your entire life. I guarantee you that. Mark my words. This has been another episode of The Quiet Room. I really appreciate you guys coming and joining me this evening. I didn't even have a sip or a bite. So in honor of that, we're going to have a bite of this delicious peanut butter and jelly sandwich right now. And I'll talk to you guys next time on The Quiet Room. Hundo's out.